Right, so you've got this concrete ferry door. I'm going to do a paint job on this one. We'll go through the stages. You can see how to make one of these doors in another video on the channel. Just make a ferry door, and this is just made out of odd items around the house, and then a mould is made from the original model, prototype, or whatever you want to call them, and then this is the result from the mould casted in concrete. So first of all, I'm going to prime or undercoat the concrete, ready to build up the colours for the door and the rocks and the fittings around the door. So first of all, I'm going to prime this with a mixture of black and brown all over, and then we'll build up layers with a dry brush technique and see what happens. Right, so there we are, we've put the undercoat on, and we'll wait overnight for the paint to cure, and then we'll start building some layers up. In the meantime, I may put another coat on just to solidify that first coat. So in the meantime, wait for that to dry and see you tomorrow, or in about 2 minutes according to this video. Right, so we put the obviously put the primer on, and that's been left for the night. I just put another coat on. Right, so on this door, I'm going to paint the door red. And try and go for like the frame, the door frame, to be like a wooden looking frame. And we'll see what colours the rocks will be a little bit later. I think I'll paint them grey, I think, or maybe sort of a browny grey. But anyway, I'll just dry some red onto the main part of the door. So a small paintbrush. And might have to go over a few times just to build those layers up. Right, so that's the first dusting of red. While that's drying, I'm just going to go around the door frame with a bit of brown, burnt umber, and do the same again. This is just a matter of building these layers up. Right, back on with the red for the door. And now we'll go over the door frame again with the brown. Again, it's a second coat of brown. Right, so I lost some video footage, so there's been a few stages done since painting the door in the frame. But what I did was, using the same technique, was to paint around the rocks with an off-white, a white mixed with a brown, just to highlight the rocks. And also over the top of that, I put a little bit of yellow, dry brushed a bit of yellow onto the rocks also, just surrounding the door to kind of give it a sort of glowy effect.
And also I dry brushed some yellow on top of the frame plus the door, just to give it that sort of worn look, and also painted the fittings on the door, the hinges with black, and the studs on the bottom of the door with black, the door knocker a brown colour, and the door handle or door knob a brown colour also. So all that needs to be done now is just to highlight the fittings, and I just dry brush some metallic paint onto the fittings. So I put some silver on the hinges, and I think I'll put some brass or bronze metallic paint onto the door knocker and the door handle. So I'll dry brush that on.
Right, here goes with the silver. And then I'll do the bronze after I've applied the silver. Right, for the finishing touch, I'm just going to dry brush some black around the edges of the frame, just to sort of create some depth and perhaps shadowing. Right, so there we are, that's pretty much done. I think we'll leave it there, and I hope the shadows and the details come out on the camera. And it was a relatively quick and easy job to do that, just using the dry brushing. The only time taken is waiting for coats of paint to dry. But there we are. I'll show you some other paint jobs. So there's the original, which was featured in how to make one of these fairy doors. As you can see, when it came out of the mould, it sort of fell apart a little bit, but that did its job. There's another paint job here with metallic painted rocks on the outside and a wooden looking door. So that is a concrete cast, the same as the other one, which of course taken from the original model prototype, which was and the mold was taken from this. I'll put the link on how to make this in the description in the video. So that was just sort of made up with bits of wood and stones out the garden and bits and pieces hanging around the house, like ring pool, snail shell, bits of plastic cut up, and some drawing pins plugged in for those stud looking things. So there's another little paint job, and thanks very much for watching, and see you soon. Over and out.